Yeah, hello again. Now we're here with some questions that people have asked, and it's about choosing your shell. So, Camilla, ask me something.
Yes. many people have problems finding the perfect body, the new body yes. they want. How do you find the perfect body?
Yeah, actually it's very easy if you throw away everything that you think about these persons which look like very, very nice. But people always attach something to them. So it's most women that have the problem. Because they choose ordinary, nice, also good-looking people, but they're ordinary. They are not wonderful and beautiful like you have never seen. They take ordinary people, so they take, maybe they have a little shape, but not much. So it's like, for women, it's like a time glass. It have to go like this. And with men, it have to go like this. So women don't choose so much of that, we can see. Because many have chosen differently while they are in the seminar.
But do you know what people want?
Yes, of course I know what they want. And I also know what they will end up with. Of course I know that, but people have to find themselves because they have to throw all beliefs about how people are looking, what are you thinking if you look at a person like that. Okay, women. It's like the womanhood is here. And for men, it's down here, okay? So women actually want, not big boobs, but they want nice boobs, okay? Not small and not too big. They want nice, because it attracts most male. So that is what they want. And they want to have shape, really good shape. They also want that, but they don't choose it, not in the beginning. So I tell them, okay, now there is a shop. You go into a shop and there's many shelves where there is all these shells with these pictures. But everybody just go into the shop and just pick one from the first shelf. They're not looking around and really look what they want. And now I can give you an example, and that's Camilla, who is interviewing me.
Yes.
That is her first shape. So now you can take a look. And of course, she is nice. It's a nice body, it's beautiful, but it's ordinary. Okay? So then, if we take, because she have of course also changed, like almost everybody. And if you see the next picture, what she have chosen, now there is more, we can say it directly. There is more sex in that, okay? But still not enough. So it's fun to see that the women just have to throw all this about sex and porn and all that. They have to throw away because we only need the shell. We just need something that everybody wants to look at. If we go down in the walking street, actually everybody, also men, ones that everybody stops and just look and just say, whoa, what was that? That was really beautiful. It saved my day.
Yeah, but for many people, like for instance, picture number one here.
Yeah.
What is wrong with her?
It's good looking. When you can choose the best, then choose the best. Then don't choose number 10. Why? Now you have the possibility of choosing the best. But we have a lot of thoughts, and that is what keeps us back. Of course, some of the students say, yeah, this is nice. Okay, and then they train for a week, 2 weeks, 1 month. Then they cannot connect to it anymore. Because now more of these thoughts, and they're gone. So now I cannot connect to it anymore. So I have to find new. And then they find more sexy, and more and more. And we can see at your last picture, that's much, much more sexy. And even if she have clothes on, she's sexy. The first one was just ordinary, if she took clothes on. Of course we should not go naked. But still, you still want that people look. And on the third picture, you will look. I would look.
Yeah, even if she has clothes on.
Even if she has clothes on, I will still look. Because it's different. There is a completely different radiation out of her. So that we are just receptors, so we just feel that, and then we just turn our heads and whoa, and then we start to think. So for women, they have to use a lot of time. Of course I will tell them, and because they don't have to go many weeks before they change, I can just say to them when they come, okay, this is nice, really beautiful woman you have found, but do a little more. Okay.
Yeah. What about men?
Men tend to know what women like. And that's the purpose of a man.
Can you explain a little more about that?
Yeah, it's because... Yeah, now I say something that is really true, but maybe many don't want to hear. But women can always get a man. But a man cannot always get a woman. And if you want to have a good-looking woman, you really have to be nice yourself. Really. So we know what, because we observe very much what women do. Oh, they look at him. Okay, how does he look? We do that unconsciously. And then that is what we do, because we want women to come to us. Of course we always hunt.
You hunt all the time.
Yes,
you observe all the time.
Yes, all men do. Even if they are gay, they hunt.
Other gay,
yeah, of course. Yeah, even people who are not gay, they just have to see if they want something. Also, but so we are hunting all the time. A woman can just have us round her pinky, and we will just follow. If she is good looking, and she have everything, then we really want to do everything. And we do, actually. So, women have the most power, men don't.
Yeah, so men are more naturally wired to know what to go for.
Yes.
Because of getting a woman.
Yeah, and we can also see it in nature. The men is very, they do everything in the nature. They fight for women. So they fight, and that we also do here. who can be the most beautiful? Because then, of course, it also attracts women. Of course, the more beautiful and, yeah, the more sexy you are, okay, then women, really, then they are hooked. Okay, but you have to do something. And not everybody can be 5 hours in the gym every day. They have other lives. So we cannot do that. But now you can just pick, so they pick. And it's not many men, which I say to them, this is too ordinary. Take one which are more men.
Yeah, whereas if you look at women, everyone picks ordinary.
Yes, everybody. And it's only a few which have not done, but yeah, we can say 98% takes ordinary, nice, beautiful women. But they're ordinary.
Is it because women don't know how much power we actually have?
Yeah, you don't know. Yeah, some know, and of course they use it, and that's okay. But women don't know how much power they have. We can just take an example. If a beautiful woman come into a shop, then all men just leave what they have and go. They don't have problem getting what they want. And you will even maybe get a discount or something.
Or the woman.
Yeah, the woman will get discount or just being served first. Mm. And then the others can just wait, because we have just focused at the beautiful woman.
So that's man's nature.
Yes, it's man's nature. This. Yeah. Yeah, because if there's more in the shop who will serve the customers, who will get her? You have to be the first, and then you just a moment, and then you go. So it's like we even fight there, but it's of course not by hands, but it's by who comes first.
It sounds very primitive.
It's very primitive. So that's why we are so easy.
So men are actually easy?
Very easy.
Okay.
But if a man is so beautiful, then it's the women who do this. Mm. Then they run around and want to do. So of course we can tilt it a little bit. But then you cannot just pick ordinary. It don't work. You have to pick completely beautiful. And that is what you want to have. So if you look at my shop, of course somebody cannot, they maybe think it's too much to have all these six packs and all that, but actually is really beautiful and slim by the waist and goes up like a V. So that's what a man should look like. Maybe people say it's too much. Yeah, but if they see, then they look, and then they start to think.
So if a woman meets this man that you have picked on the street, they will look at him?
Yes, immediately. And they will automatically observe everything. If they can see if he's married or see if there's somebody he's walking with or whatever. And if there's somebody who is walking with him that is not so beautiful, then they attach to them. Because they are more easy, but then they are closer.
Okay. What about the faces? You said in the last interview you had chosen 3 faces.
Yes, I have chosen 3 faces. I have one from my youth. I think I was about 22 to 25 years old. You can look at this. I don't have many pictures, so that's why this is a little funny picture. And then I have chosen the one from my shell. So So you can also see that, how this is. And then I have chosen, that was just recently, I have chosen the third one. And this is Keanu Reeves, because when you put these three faces together, it will look really good. Of course, you can see later when I have done.
When will you have done? That's maybe a question many thinks about.
Yes, because they want to have, they want to be sure that this can be done. So I will not tell you a date, and I also write that on the internet. No dates, because you have to have a little patience, because this can take time.
When you have changed,
yes,
to the new, completely changed,
yeah,
does it last, or do you go back to the old body if you don't keep practicing?
No, it lasts. Because in the meditations I have done, so you always put energy into your new shell, so you will not age. So your new body will not age, it will be same. And the energy is same. So you have same energy, and you have same body. Of course you can choose to make a new one, because now you are much better to do. Now you know it works. So now your brain can much easier do, so it don't take so long. And then you can just change again.
But it will never go back to
No, it can. It can't. Because the old body is gone. So it can never go back. What should it go back to? Because we have just the shell. The other thing is gone. So it can only go back to the shell. So never back to the old one.
So you say men want a V-shaped,
yes,
body, women want an hourglass
shape, yeah,
shaped body. Is this for everyone?
Of course it depends, because some people are maybe not attracted to it, like the hourglass of women. But it, if you talk to the women, then it's because they have to be more powerful. So they choose women with many muscles and not so much shape. But it's because of their upbringing and what environment they are in. When all this is gone, then they cannot connect to this person anymore, this shell anymore. Then they have to pick new. And then it's always like this. Always.
So the perfect shape is like this.
Yeah, that's what everybody will end up with. So, yeah, that's just the way it is. It's not because, of course, there's some, because there's also bodybuilders who build the bodies to do to look specific. Yeah, but that's a sport. That's just sculpting your body. Have nothing to do with this.
So what if women think it's too much sex, or it's too much porn, or what do you say to them?
I say it have nothing to do with the person which you take the shell from. Have nothing to do with that. You just have to look at the shell. It doesn't matter if they have been addicts or they are crazy or whatever, or they do stupid things. It has nothing to do with that. It's only the shape we are after. And the shape we are after is one that everybody really notice and see. Because then we get energy all the time.
But does everyone wants to be noticed on the street?
No, not when they come.
No, but
later.
Inside.
Yeah, inside, deep inside, yes, of course.
Everyone.
Everyone. And if there is somebody who say, yeah, I don't want, then you lie completely.
So it's also about being honest,
yes,
with yourself.
You have to be completely honest with yourself. And of course many people have problems to do that. Because they always hide something. They don't want to be an open book. So they always are like that. But that's okay, and it's a process. So, of course, we have had many who have had maybe 6 or 7 different shells, and that's fine. They just have to have one they can connect to. And when the mental state is changed gradually, okay, then you cannot connect to the old one, then you have to have new. So it's also a process. Mm-hmm. And if people come and say to me, Kay, I cannot find out what I should have, then I will tell them what they have to choose.
So you know.
I know, exactly. But of course, if they cannot connect to it, then it's not so efficient. And then I say, okay, take a little less, maybe, so they can connect to it, because that's the most important. Because we have to have all this energy inside. So you have to be convenient with the shell that you have chosen.
But they will always end up
yes.
with the shell you have,
yes.
you know.
Yes, always. Of course, we cannot say 100% because my student is not finished yet, but we will see.
Some other questions. What do you do if your family cannot recognize you when you are in the new shell?
Yeah, now it's not like it happens suddenly like this. It happens gradually. And you can also see me, I change gradually. Of course, from my family, they have just seen, he is very brown and he has maybe lost a few kilos. But now the other day my father said, Kay, God damn, you have changed. So now he start to recognize it. Before he saw it, but maybe he couldn't say anything. So of course it's gradually. And I do it quick compared to how you do, or how people which are on the seminar do. So it will be even slower. So people will notice it, they will see that you change. But it's just normal. It's same here. We are here every day, you see yourself, you don't see that it changes. But when somebody comes who have not seen you in a few months, then they say, oh, so much have happened, but you don't see it.
Yeah. Many people also ask about passports.
Yeah.
And fingerprints.
Yeah, it's always these logical things that what about my fingerprint and what about my passport, and then I said, just take it easy. It's only a positive problem. Yeah, because if you have changed your fingerprint, then so what? You can just go and say, this is me. No, it's not, we can see your fingerprints is different. I don't know, but I have all my papers, I have everything. So of course they have to trust it. And of course if it's in your passport that you are 80 years old and you look maybe 25, then maybe they think, what the hell have he done? But if the rest match, then no problem.
A lot of people also ask about age. Maybe yes. they want a model who's 35 or 40.
Yes.
Is that good?
Yeah, that's okay to pick one. That is, if they have everything, then it's okay. But you have to pick an age between 20 and 22. And that's because of the energy. The energy at that point is some sparkling energy, bubbling sensations, and that is what we want. That is what we want the rest of our lives.
But what if a person doesn't want to look like 22?
They don't. If they want to look old, fine, but they will still have the this energy, bubbling sensation energy.
So it's the energy of the 20-year-old?
Yes, it's not, you cannot look back and see how you were when you were 20 or 22. No, it's the energy we are. that adventurous energy who wants to explore things and do stuff. That's what we want. Okay. Yeah, then this was the questions we have had on our website or Facebook or emails. So you can always write us and then we will bring an interview. And if we see something, like we have taken this up with picking a shape, okay, if there's something more that will come, we will also bring it. So, see you. Bye.